See here in this problem, here the trans function for a linear time invariant system is given as 1 by s plus 1. So let assume that g of s is given as 1 by s plus 1. But here we want the steady state value for the unit impulse response. But we know that for unit impulse response, the steady state value is defined as limit s tends to 0 s into g of s. But g of s is given as 1 by s plus 1. Now substitute here, then it becomes limit s tends to 0 s into 1 by s plus 1. So after substituting that limit s tends to 0, it results equal to 0. I mean 0 into anything, total becomes 0. So the steady state value for the unit impulse response for the given trans function is 0. So from the options, option is the correct option. See here in this problem, here for a function f of t, the Laplace transform is given as f of s is equal to 5 by s into s square plus 3s plus 2. So, but here we want the initial value for the function f of t. So, according to the initial value theorem in Laplace transforms, we know that limit t tends to 0 f of t equal to limit s tends to infinity s into f of s. Okay. Now, substitute here f of s in this function, then you get the initial value for f of t. So limit s tends to infinity s into, so f of s is 5 by s into s square plus 3s plus 2. Here s will going to cancel, so then it becomes limit s tends to infinity, so bring here s square is common, so then it becomes 5 by s square divided by 1 plus 3 by s plus 2 by s square. Now substitute s tends to infinity here. So 5 by infinity means 0, 0 by 1 plus 0 plus 0. So 0 by 1 means 0. So from the options, option D is the correct option. So this is the initial value for the given function f of t. See here in this problem, here for a tachometer a sensitivity of 5 volts per 1000 rpm is given. So what is the gain constant for the tachometer? So for the tachometer, the gain constant is defined as V by omega. So here omega is the angular frequency. So this the ratio is called as gain constant. So when you observe here, sensitivity is given. So sensitivity is given as 5 volts per 1000 rpm. So observe here, volts is given. Means 5 volts is given here. And RPM is the 1000, means number of rotation is 1000 per minute. Now we want the angular frequency here. So we got V is equal to 5 volts. Now angular frequency is defined as omega equal to 2 pi n by 60. Now substitute n in this equation, then we get angular frequency omega is equal to 2 pi into 1000 divided by 60. Now substitute in this equation for finding the gain constant. So that's equal to, so V is, we got 5. So 5 by 2 pi into 1000 into here 60. So by applying the inverse here, so the ratio is 0.048 volts per radian per second. So this is the gain constant for the tachometer. So from the options, option B is the correct option. See here in this problem, what is the unit impulse response for the given figure? So here two blocks are given which are cascaded to each other. So first of all, find the trans function. So that is response by excitation at equal to h of s, that's equal to, here two blocks are cascaded, that means product of the two blocks, that is 1 by s into 1 by s plus 1. So that's equal to 1 by s into s plus 1. So first of all, convert into two fractions. Okay, that means by applying the positive fraction, we will get it 1 by s minus of 1 by s plus 1. So both will be equal. Okay, there is no change, and this is h of s. But we want the unit impulse response. So apply the inverse Laplace transform for the given h of s. So then we get the unit impulse response. So that is equal to h of t equal to inverse Laplace of 1 by s means u of t minus of, and here e power minus t u of t. So bring u of t common here, then we get h of t equal to 1 minus e power minus t u of t. So that is nothing but 1 minus e power minus t or 1 minus e power minus t into u of t. And this is the unit impulse response for the given diagram. Okay. So from the options, option B the correct option. See here the compensator given, that is called as the lead compensator given here. So first of all, write the transfer function for the lead compensator. So that is alpha into 1 plus Ts divided by 1 plus alpha Ts. So when you observe that, so T nothing but 0.3 and alpha T means 0.1. Okay, so first of all write that. So alpha T equal to 0.1 and T we have 0.3. Now substitute here in this equation, alpha is equal to 0.1 by 0.3. So that's equal to 1 by 3. So and it is a constant value here. Now we want the here maximum phase shift. So the maximum phase shift is defined as pi m equal to sine inverse of 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. So where alpha we got 1 by 3. Now substitute alpha in this equation. Then look at the maximum phase shift. So that's equal to sine inverse of 1 minus 1 by 3 divided by 1 plus 1 by 3. So that's equal to sine inverse of 1 by 2. That equal to 30 degrees. So the maximum phase shift is 30 degrees. So from the options, option C is the correct option. See here in this problem, here phase leading compensating network is given here. That is GC of S is equal to 10 into 1 plus 0.04S divided by 1 plus 0.01S. So but we know that the standard network formula, that is standard lead compensating network, is defined as alpha into 1 plus T1S divided by 1 plus alpha T1S. So by comparing with this, we will get T1 equal to 0.04 and alpha T1 equal to 0.01. So but we want the maximum phase rate frequency at a frequency of, here given as in radians. So we know we have the one formula, that is omega m equal to 1 by root of alpha T into root T. Okay. Now substitute, your T means T1. Okay. Now substitute these two values here. So this will be here and this will be here. So then we will get 1 by root of alpha T1 means 0.01 into 1 by root T means 0.04. So by using the calculator, we will get the value is 50 radians per second. So this is the angular frequency, that is maximum phase rate angular frequency. So that is 50 radians per second. So from the options, option is the correct option. See here in this problem. Here for a given network, the transfer function g of s is given as 1 by s plus 4 divided by 1 plus s plus 5. So and this transfer function is defined for lead compensator. So then for what is the maximum phase lead frequency? So here when you observe the option, that is angular frequency there. So first of all, write the standard lead compensator transfer function, that is alpha into 1 plus T1 s divided by 1 plus alpha T1s. So by comparing with that, we will get T equal to 1 by 4 and alpha T equal to 1 by 25. Okay. So these are the values when comparing the standard transfer function. Okay. Now we want the angular frequency, that is maximum phase rate angular frequency. So that is defined as omega m equal to 1 by root of T into root of alpha T. So that's equal to 1 by root of 1 by 4 into root of 1 by 25. So that's equal to root of 25 into 4. That's equal to 10 radians per second. So this is the maximum angular frequency, means phase rate angular frequency. So from the options, option C is the correct option for the given problem. See here. So for a control system, g of s is equal to 4 by s into s plus 3. The feedback is given as h of s is equal to 1 by s. So for the closed loop system, what type of system given system it is? So first of all, find the g of s into h of s. So from that we can say that what type of system it is. So g of s into h of s. So that's equal to 1 by s square, here 4 is there, s plus 3. So what is type means, how many poles are there at origin. So we observe here 2 poles are there, so at origin. So it this information is defined as type, so means type 2 system. So the given system is type 2 system. A2 means 2 poles are there at origin. So from the options, option B the correct option. See here in this problem, here for a unit feedback system, g of s is equal to k into s plus 2 all divided by s plus 14 into s plus 18 given. So then what is the value of k to yield 10% of error in the steady state? So first of all understand here, g of s into h of s. So here h of s is given as unit feedback, so it is nothing but g of s only. So when observing g of s, how many poles are there at origin? 0 poles are there. So it is a type 0 system. So for type 0 system, the steady state error for step input is a by 1 plus k, and for ramp input is infinity, and parabolic input is infinity. So defaultly, so we are going to calculate for step input, so that is a by 1 plus k. Here k means position error constant, that is called as kp. So that is capital A by 1 plus kp, so that is ESS. First of all, find the kp value. How can you find the kp value here? For unit step input, the position error constant, that is kp, is defined as kp equal to limit s tends to 0 g of s. Now substitute g of s here, so that is k into s plus 2 all divided by s plus 14 into s plus 18. Now s is tends to 0, now substitute 0 here, so then we get k into 2 all divided by 14 into 18. So this is called as kp value. Now substitute in this equation, here m is 1, that is gain is 1, okay. So then we get here 1 by 1 plus, so by simplifying this we will get k by 21, that is ESS. So ESS is already given here, so that is 10%. So for what value of k? 10% of steady state error. So steady state error is given as 10%, so that is 0.01 equal to 1 by 1 plus k by 21. So by simplifying this we will get 10 equal to 1 plus k by 21. From this k by 21 equal to 9, or k equal to 189. So here k we got 189. So from the options, option B is the correct option. See here, for a unit feedback system, the open loop transfer function g of s is given as k by s into s plus 10. So for the overall transfer function, the damping ratio is given as 0.5. So then what is the value of k? So first of all construct the transfer function, so that is g of s divided by 1 plus g of s into h of s. So this is called as transfer function. So but here h of s is the unit feedback system. Now substitute g of s, and h of s is 1, so that's equal to k by s into s plus 10 divided by 1 plus g of s, means k by s into s plus 10. So into h of s means 1, okay. So that's equal to k by s square plus 10s plus k. Now compare with the standard transfer function, that is t of s equal to omega n square divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. So when you compare the denominator for both of these, we will get omega n square is equal to k, and 2 zeta omega n equal to 10. Now this is considered as 1, and this is the second equation. So from the second equation we will get omega n equal to 10 by 2 zeta. So where zeta is given as 0.5, that is called as damping ratio. So that is equal to 10 by 2 into 0.5, so that is equal to 10. Now substitute omega n, that is natural frequency, in equation 1, so that is k equal to 10 square, that is equal to 100. So the k value is 100 when damping ratio is 0.5. So from the options, the k value is 100, that is option B.